It may soon become a crime if you lie about whether a pet of yours is a service or emotional support animal in Missouri.
Two state lawmakers are pushing a bill that would make misrepresenting an animal to get special treatment and housing a misdemeanor.
Our Francis Lynn spoke with a dog trainer and a property owner for us to get the story about the increasing number of people who try to get their animals to live in properties that don't allow animals.
Yeah, so the dog trainer I spoke to says it's very hard to find the balance between protecting property owners from people trying to take advantage of the system, but also protecting people who really do need service animals.
As a landlord, I feel like we've lost our rights to protect our property.
Doug Acklin is the property manager at Brentwood Management, a property that does not allow pets.
I've been doing this for 30 years. In recent years, it's just getting worse and worse, I feel like. Everybody says, well, all you need is an emotional support letter and you can have a pet.
An emotional support animal can't go in public, but they can go into rental properties that normally don't allow dogs.
John Lopez, founder of Canines for Camo, says the bill needs to target people who are taking advantage of the system.
I think there does have to be some type of legislation that gets the fake people who are doing this with dogs that aren't trained, there's some type of repercussion for that. But I think it still needs to protect the people who are doing it legitimately.
Because property owners feel they are in a tough spot.
Pets create odor problems and damage to the property, which many times the tenant doesn't have the money to repair. So we're stuck with the bill.
Here are some pictures Acklin sent me from pet damages.
Usually the dogs are the worst because they scratch on the doors, they scratch the carpet. There's no breed restriction with the emotional support, so we have people with pit bulls. I also feel like it is a liability issue with us because if someone would get bit, you know, I feel like the liability is going to fall back on us.
And that's for emotional support animals. As for actual service animals,
the problem we're having is a lot of people are skipping the step of actually training them and just buying a vest and taking them everywhere with them, and they're not trained at all.
Lopez says if a dog wears a service vest, it should be properly trained.
These dogs in public not acting like they should, and so it makes it harder on people who actually need them.
Now, the bill was heard in the committee on Monday, but no vote was taken yet.
We'll see where it goes. Francis Lynn tonight. Thanks. And